Okay, so in today's video, I wanted to talk about the Manfrotto compact light. I've had it for a couple of weeks, and I gotta say, spoiler alert, it's probably my favorite tripod of the year. Now, this wasn't released this year, it was actually released a couple of years ago, but this is the first time I've actually tested it, and compared to my other tripods, I think this is my go-to tripod, and I'm gonna explain to you why. So, everything depends on what type of style you have, okay? So, judging by the name, the Manfrotto compact light, it is very lightweight and it is very compact, as you can see. There are lighter and smallers, but the smaller and the lighter you go, the more compromises you have to make. You know, they might not be as stable or they might not get as tall and stuff like that. This is a good compromise that I would say. Now, I actually do have a different brand that I've used for a couple of years. It's actually smaller and a little less weight. It's very stable and it's good. But the thing that I didn't like about that one is that it had these swivel legs and I just prefer the snap-on, you know, and for years I've been just missing these snap-on things because it just feels more conclusive that yes, the legs are fixed, and when it's the screwy version, I just don't like it. Now, you can remove this ball head right here. I personally like this ball head, and it's actually one of the reasons why I do like it. But if you want like something like a clip-on thing where you can just snap on your camera every time and you don't want to have to, you know, screw to attach it, there are other alternatives. Like I said, you could replace this ball head, but I actually like this version, and everything comes down to what type of style that you have when you're filming. Like, I can imagine that there are photographers and videographers that they need to switch between cameras instead of lenses, and they like to be able to quickly just remove it and just put in another camera, you know, because they're working fast. Maybe they want to recharge, they don't have time to recharge the batteries or change the batteries, so they just want to flip between different cameras. So I understand that, but for me, I don't really need that. For me, it's pretty much a hassle. I have to have this little plate I have to attach to the back and then put it on. It's too much work. I prefer it like this. And also, this one is actually very interesting. It's a very quick way to just screw it on. Like, back in the day, you had to like screw it on like so, but this time there is like this little ring beneath it and you just screw it on pretty quickly if you're doing it the right way. Yeah, something like that. That's really good. And you know, you can wiggle it around in all different directions. It's pretty stable. Again, this is a ball head and I really like that. And yeah, it gets pretty tall when you move it out to the full extension of what you can use this tripod. So it gets pretty tall and it's pretty low also. The main reason why I prefer these compact light versions is because I like to put it in my backpack when I'm out hiking and doing stuff, and I just really prefer the small factor format. But if I'm shooting at home or in a studio, then I prefer something more stable, like something that I'm shooting on right now. So it really depends on what you want to use this for. So I would recommend this for people basically who are and want to have a tripod on the go that is stable, that is light and compact and all of that. You know, the perfect compromise. That's what this is. And for my money's worth, I think this is very cheap. It's a Manfrotto, so it's a good brand. This is premium quality. It's not fiber or anything like that, but it's good. You know, it's really good. Trust me, I've tested a lot of tripods, and this one I fully recommend. I really enjoy using this one. So big thumbs up for this one. Good job, Manfrotto. Okay, that's all I have for today. Hope you enjoyed this one, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.